Welcome to my CBSE English teacher. Today let's look at the line by line explanation of the chapter A Question of Trust from Class 10 English. If you're watching my video for the first time, please subscribe. You can listen to the explanations of chapters from classes 10, 11 and 12 English. And don't forget to press the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I upload a video. Let's move on to the video now. About the author. Victor Canning is the author of A Question of Trust. He was a prolific British writer of novels and thrillers who flourished during the 1950s and 70s. So let's move on to the lesson. The lesson's name is A Question of Trust. What is the meaning of trust? Trust means strong belief or faith in someone or something. When you believe in somebody, you know that the person or the thing is capable of doing whatever you say or want. So the strong belief in someone or something is called trust. We also saw the word trust in the lesson, The Thief's Story. So you know what the meaning of trust is. So let's move on to the lesson now. Everyone thought that Horace Danby was good. So this is a story about two thieves, and we'll see what trust has to do between these two thieves. So everyone thought that Horace Danby was a good, honest citizen. So Horace Danby is the person here, and everyone believed that he was a good man. An honest citizen means somebody who follows the rules and regulations and does not do anything against the law. He was about 50 years old and unmarried, and he lived with a housekeeper who worried over his health. So he was 50-year-old man and he was not married, and he lived with a housekeeper. So there was a housekeeper to take care of him, and the housekeeper was always worried about his health. In fact, he was usually very well and happy except for attacks of hay fever in summer. So he was always happy, but only one thing that bothered him was hay fever, especially during summer. What is this hay fever? Hay fever is nothing but allergy caused due to pollen grains. Pollen grains come from the flowers. So he made locks and was successful enough at his business to have two helpers. So what was his job? What was his profession? His profession was to make locks, and he was successful. That means he was very successful and he was able to earn a lot of money at his business too. And this was known by the fact that he had two helpers. Two people were there to work with him, and they were doing a very good business. Yes, Horace Danby was good and respectable, but not completely honest. So what is the writer saying? He says that Horace Danby was a respectable man. That means everybody knew that he was a good man, but then he was not totally honest. So there is something about him which makes him tell that he is not an honest man. 15 years ago, Horace had served his first and only sentence in a prison library. So why does the writer say that he was not honest? Because 15 years ago he had gone to jail once and he had served in the prison library. He loved rare, expensive books. So Horace Danby loved to read books. So he robbed a safe every year. Each year he planned carefully just what he would do, stole enough to last for 12 months, and secretly bought the books he loved through an agent. So he's saying that Horace Danby loved to read books, especially rare and expensive books. So how does he get money to buy all these books? He plans a robbery every year. So every year once he would rob, and that money would be enough for him to last for 1 year. And with that money, what he would do? He would buy expensive books through some agent so that he would not be caught. So he steals money only for buying books, expensive and rare books. Now, walking the bright July sunshine, he felt sure that this year's robbery was going to be as successful as all the others. So now it was July, and as he was walking, he was planning another robbery, and he also thought that, like every time, this time also I will be successful. So for 2 weeks he had been studying the house at Shotover Grange. So he had already found a house, and the name of that house was Shotover. It was located at a place called Shotover Grange. And for 2 weeks, he was just studying the house, looking at its rooms, its electrical wiring, its paths, and its garden. So he was just looking at it, like how he had to plan, how he should go inside and all that. So for 2 weeks, he was making all the arrangements. This afternoon, the two servants who remained in the Grange while the family was in London had gone to the movies. So on that afternoon, what happened? There were no people in the house. The two servants who were there, they had gone to watch a movie. And the family was in London. So he was sure that that is the best time to make the robbery, because he had already planning and looking at this house for 2 weeks. Horace saw them go and he felt happy in spite of a little tickle of hay fever in his nose. So Horace was very happy because that afternoon he saw that the two servants from the house had left for the movie. But only thing that was bothering him was his hay fever, because it was tickling his nose. Because whenever the dust enters his nose, he feels like sneezing. So that's the only thing he was worried about. So he came out from behind the garden wall, his tools carefully packed in a bag on his back. So now he reached the house and slowly he jumped from the behind garden wall, and his tools were all packed in his backpack. So there were about 15,000 pounds worth of jewels in the Grange safe. So he knew that there was enough money in the house. And what money is there? 15,000 pounds of worth of jewels was there inside the safe inside the house. Okay, if he sold them one by one, he expected to get at least 5,000, enough to make him happy for another year. So he knew that all those jewels, even if he sell them one by one, he would get enough money that would last for 1 year, and he'll be able to buy whatever books he want. There were 3 very interesting books coming up for sale in the autumn. So he had already planned and he had already come to know about some 3 interesting books, and he was planning to buy them with this money. Now he would get the money he wanted to buy them. He had seen the housekeeper hang the key to the kitchen door on a hook outside. So he also noticed where the key was hung, and that was on the hook outside the kitchen door. So he put on a pair of gloves, took the key and opened the door. So nobody was there. He already knew where the key was. So he took the key and opened the door, and he was wearing gloves so that his fingerprints would not be noticed. So he was always careful not to leave any fingerprints. A small dog was lying in the kitchen. Okay, so when he opened the door and went inside, he saw that there was a small dog inside the kitchen. It stirred, made a noise, and moved its tail in a friendly way. So the dog did not bark by looking at him, it just wagged its tail in a friendly manner. "All right, Sherry," Horace said as he passed. So the dog's name was Sherry. So he might have already made friends with the dog, because we know that he was already planning this robbery from 2 weeks. All you had to do to keep dogs quiet was to call them by their right names and show them love. So he also knew the trick how to keep the dog quiet. So if you call a name by its if you call a dog by its name, and if you show them some love, some dogs do remain quiet. So in this way, he was able to tame this dog as well. So it did not make any noise, it just wagged its tail. The safe was in the drawing room behind a rather poor painting. So there was a big painting in the drawing room, and the safe that had all these jewels was behind the painting. Horace wondered for a moment whether he should collect pictures instead of books. So by looking at the painting, he suddenly wondered whether he should start collecting paintings, because paintings are also very expensive. But they took up too much room. But then he thought that paintings need a lot of space. So he discarded that thought of collecting paintings. In a small house, books were better. So he thought that it is better to collect books, because he had a small house too. So there was a great bowl of flowers on the table, and Horace felt his nose tickle. So here what happened? There was a bowl of flowers kept on the table. And from the flowers, we know that pollens come out all around. And so he suddenly had this tickle of his nose, because we know that he has hay fever. He gave a little sneeze and then put down his bag. So he started sneezing, and because he was sneezing, he put down his bag. He carefully arranged his tools. He had 4 hours before the servants returned. So what happened? He had only 4 hours because the servants had gone to the movie. The safe was not going to be hard to open. After all, he had lived with locks and safes all his life. So it is not difficult for him to open a safe, because we know that his profession is making locks, and he is he can easily open all kinds of locks and safes. So it was not a difficult job for him. The burglar alarm was poorly built, so the burglar alarm that was there was not of good quality. He went into the hall to cut its wire. So before the alarm could ring, he knew that he should cut the wire. So he went into the hall. He came back and sneezed loudly as the smell of the flowers came to him again. So what happened? When he was coming back, he sneezed again loudly because of the flowers. How foolish people are when they own valuable things, Horace thought. So he was thinking about how foolish people are because they keep all these things here and they have this bad quality of alarm and all that. So a magazine article had described the house, giving a plan of all the rooms and a picture of this room. So he had come to know most of this through a magazine in which the house was, an article about the house was given. Even the plan of the house was there and how the rooms were all arranged, and even about the picture, about that painting we saw in the beginning, about that also it was given in the magazine. So the writer had even mentioned that the painting hid a safe. So you see, the writer who wrote about this house had also mentioned that there was a safe behind the painting. So that is why he was saying that how foolish these rich people are, because they give all the details to somebody and it's all printed in a magazine. But Horace found that the flowers were hindering him in his work. He buried his face in his handkerchief. Now, because he was being disturbed by the flowers and the pollen, what did he do? He used a handkerchief to tie his nose. Then he heard a voice say from the doorway, "What is it?" So suddenly what happened? He heard a voice, somebody talking. And what did that person say? "What is it? A cold or hay fever?" So somebody is asking him because they heard him, because that person heard him sneeze. So do you have cold or do you have hay fever? Before he could think, Horace said, "Hay fever," and found himself sneezing again. And before he could think who was asking the question, he answered. He said that he has hay fever, and again he started to sneeze. The voice went on, "You can cure it with a special treatment, you know, if you find out just what plant gives you the disease." So the person replied that you can cure your disease if you know what plant is giving you that disease or what is causing the disturbance. "I think you'd better see a doctor if you're serious about your work." So that person is also giving him an advice to go and see the doctor, because if you want to work properly, you should get rid of your disease. So that's what the person said. "I heard you from the top of the house just now." So the person said that, "I heard your voice when I was on the top floor. That's why I came down." So it was a quiet, kindly voice, but one with a firmness in it. So what kind of voice was that? It was a very kind voice, but at the same time it was very firm. That means it was very strong. A woman was standing in the doorway and Sherry was rubbing against her. So the person who was talking is a woman. Okay. And Sherry, who is Sherry? Sherry is a dog. So that was going and standing very close to this lady. She was young, quite pretty, and was dressed in red. So this lady who spoke was a young lady. She was very good looking and she was wearing a red color dress. She walked to the fireplace and straightened the ornaments there. So she walked towards the fireplace. What's the fireplace? Where we keep the firewood and all and burn it so that the room becomes warm. So above that there were some ornaments, some decorative items. So she was just making them all right. "Down, Sherry," she said. So she wanted the dog to sit down silently. "Anyone would think I had been away for a month." So she's saying that people will think that I was not here for a month. She smiled at Horace and went on, "However, I came back just in time, though I didn't expect to meet a burglar." So she's saying that people think that I am not here in my house, and but then I came back at the right time and I never expected to meet a burglar. Burglar means thief. Horace had some hope because she seemed to be amused at the meeting. So Horace had some hope. That means he was quite sure that she was having some, she was speaking in a kind manner, so she might not be harsh with him. She might not hand over him to the police because she was speaking in an amusing manner. He might avoid trouble if he treated her right away. So he thought that he will avoid trouble if she was good to him. He replied, "I didn't expect to meet one of the family." So he also told her that, "I didn't expect to meet a family member from this house." She nodded, "I see what an inconvenience it is for you to meet me. What are you going to do?" So she's asking him, "Okay, you never expected me, but when you saw me, it has caused a lot of inconvenience. So what are you going to do now?" Horace said, "My first thought was to run." "Of course you could do that, but I would telephone the police and tell them all about you. They'd get you at once." So he said that, "My first thought was to run, but when I met you." So immediately she said that, "No, if you do that, I will call the police and tell them to catch you, and they will surely get you." Horace said, "I would of course cut the telephone wires first," and then he hesitated. So he told her that, "If you are going to call the police, the first thing I would do is go and cut the wires, and then I would run." He hesitated, a smile on his face. "I would make sure that you could do nothing for some time. A few hours would be enough." So she said that, "I'll see to it that you will not be able to do anything." She looked at him seriously. "You'd hurt me?" So she was also afraid whether the thief would hurt her. So she asked him whether you would hurt me. Horace paused and then said, "I think I was trying to frighten you when I said that." So he said that he was only trying to frighten her. "You didn't frighten me," Horace suggested. "It would be nice if you would forget you ever saw me." So he was telling her that it's better you forget that you saw me. That means he wanted her not to tell about this meeting to the police. "Let me go." And so he told her that she must allow him to go. The voice was suddenly sharp. "Why should I? You were going to rob me. If I let you go, you will only rob someone else." So what did she say? She said that, "I will not allow you to escape, because if you escape, you're going to rob some other house. Society must be protected from men like you." So she said that people should be protected from people like you, because you're a thief and you steal everybody's belongings. Horace smiled. "I'm not a man who threatens society." So immediately he told her that, "I'm not a thief who goes and frightens people. I steal only from those who have a lot of money. I steal for a very good reason." So he was trying to tell her that he was not a normal thief. He's not a thief like others. He wanted to tell her that he only steals for a good reason, and he steals money only from people who have a lot of money. And I hate the thought of prison. And he says that he didn't like to go to prison. She laughed and he begged, thinking that he had persuaded her. So he just smiled and he thought that he had given her a good explanation about why he should be let out. "Look, I have no right to ask you for anything, but I am desperate. Let me go, and I promise never to do this kind of thing again. I really mean it." So he just was begging her and telling her that, "Let me go. I'm doing this for a particular reason." That means I'm stealing for a special reason, and I'll not do this kind of thing hereafter. So please let me go. So he just wanted her to let him go. She was silent, watching him closely. Then she said, "You are really afraid of going to prison, aren't you?" So she asked him, "Okay, so you are really afraid of going to prison." She came over to him, shaking her head. "I have always liked the wrong kind of people." So she told him, she came closer to him and told him that she always chose wrong people, and she liked wrong people for certain reasons. She picked up a silver box from the table and took a cigarette from it. Horace, eager to please her and seeing that she might help him, took off his gloves and gave her his cigarette lighter. So the lady was about to smoke, and what did Horace do? He thought that maybe removing his gloves would make her happy. And so he removed his gloves and he took out his cigarette lighter and gave it to her. "You let me go?" He held the lighter towards her. "Yes, but only if you'll do something for me." So why was she very quiet? Because she wanted something from Horace. So what did she say? "Yes, I'll let you go, but if you do me a favor." So she wanted Horace to do something for her. "Anything you say." So he said that, "Whatever you say, I'm ready to do it for you. Before we left London, I promised my husband to take my jewels to our bank, but I left it here in the safe." So she's saying that she was going to give her jewels for keeping it in the bank. She told this to her husband and she had forgotten to take the jewels along with her. "So I want to wear them to a party tonight. So I came down to them, but..." So she's saying that she had actually forgotten to take the jewels. And then she's saying that, "I came here just to take the jewels because I want to wear them for a party tonight." Horace smiled. "You've forgotten the numbers to open the safe, haven't you?" "Yes," replied the young lady. So immediately Horace says, "I know that you have forgotten the number to open the safe." So she immediately said, "Yes, just leave it to me and you'll have all of them within an hour." So Horace said that, "Don't worry, within 1 hour I'll take out the jewels and give it to you." So Horace was ready to help the owner because she was asking for her jewels and she said that she forgot the number of the safe. "But I'll have to break your safe." "Don't worry about that, my husband won't be here for a month and I'll have the safe mended by that time." So what did he say? He says that, "I'll have to break your safe," but immediately she says that, "Don't worry because my husband is not here and I can get it repaired by the time he comes back." And within an hour, Horace had opened the safe, given her the jewels and gone happily away. So he did his job. Within 1 hour, he broke open the safe, took the jewels and gave it to her and he went away happily. Why happily? Because he was not caught or handed over to the police. For 2 days, he kept his promise to the kind young lady. On the morning of the third day, however, he thought of the books and he knew he would have to look for another safe. So what happened? He had promised the lady that if she let him go, he would never rob again. So for 2 days, he didn't do anything. But on the third day, again, he remembered his books. He wanted them very badly. And again, he decided that he should do one more robbery. But he never got the chance to begin his plan. By the noon, a policeman arrested him for the jewel robbery at Shotover Grange. But what happened? He was not able to carry out his plan because in the afternoon, a policeman came and arrested him for robbery at Shotover Grange. So what is Shotover Grange? The place where he had gone to steal the jewels. His fingerprints, for he had opened the safe without the gloves, were all over the room and no one believed him when he said that the wife of the owner of the house had asked him to open the safe for her. So why was he caught? Because his fingerprints were found all over the house. And even he told the story to the police that it was the owner, the lady of the house, who told him to open the, break the safe and take all the jewels. But then nobody believed him. The wife herself, a grey-haired, sharp-tongued woman of 60, said that the story was nonsense. But now comes the real owner of the house. She was actually an old lady and she was 60 years old. But the lady whom we saw at the house was a young lady, a pretty lady who was dressed in red. So we understand that she is also another thief and she is not the house owner. The real house owner is actually an old woman. Horace is now the assistant librarian in the prison. So again he has gone to prison. He is taken to prison for the robbery and he is working as the assistant librarian in the prison. He often thinks of the charming, clever young lady who was in the same profession as he was. So he keeps thinking about that young lady who cheated him because she was also in the same profession. What is the profession? Both of them were thieves who had tricked him. So she has actually tricked him, cheated him by telling that she was the owner, but actually she was a thief. He gets very angry when anyone talks about honor among thieves. So when anybody talks about honor among thieves, what is this honor among thieves? See, when thieves, they believe that they are supposed to help each other in their work. But here what happened? The lady, she was also a thief, but she came and cheated him. So that is why he gets angry when anybody talks about the honor among thieves. So Horace Danby was a respectable man. He made locks and had two helpers. So he stole once in a year just for getting books, buying his rare and expensive books. So in his plan to steal, he was cheated by a young lady posing to be the owner of the house. So that is why he gets angry when anybody talks about honor among thieves. Actually, thieves are supposed to help each other, but then here she cheated him and took away all the money and escaped, and he was in prison finally. I hope you liked today's video. For more informative videos, subscribe to my CBSE English teacher. Like, share and give your valuable comments below. Thank you for watching.